Hey, Dr. Notley here, Winnipeg Chiropractor and Athletic Therapist. And in this video, I'm going to show you ways to self-myofascial release your hamstring muscles. So when we're looking at the hamstring muscles, they actually originate up underneath your glute max, your butt muscle, and they travel down across the back of your knee. There's actually three of them. There's your bicep femoris, your semimembranosus, and your semitendinosus. Semitendinosus and semimembranosus come down to the inside of the knee, whereas biceps femoris goes to the outside of the knee. So we can hit different areas when we're doing the self-myofascial release. So let's look at a few ways that we can do that. So most people are familiar with foam rolling. We can get our foam roller. We can get up on the hamstring and we just start massaging it. And you can kind of see, I'm kind of just like slowly working my way up to the bony part of my butt, all the way up. And what you might discover is you might discover some spots that are tender. You just can't quite get in there. Now, we have to realize that there is the sciatic nerve that travels down there in between the hamstring muscles. So you might be wanting to get in there and dig in onto sciatic nerve, and it won't like that. So if you are feeling burning pain, shooting pain down into the leg, you might be working on this nerve, so be careful. So if you can't quite get in deep enough with the foam roller, what you can then do is you can either use just generally a stick. Some people have different sticks that are made specifically for self-myofascial release. You can also use a stick. You can also use a device like this. Sadly, this device isn't made anymore, at least for now, but it can be copied if you've got some skills. You get a dowel, get a ball, drill a hole in it, and you get the same thing. So what you're going to do is you're going to take the ball and find that tender spot. Now, if you're right in the middle and you're getting that burning, remember that might be, or that really painful spot, it might be the sciatic nerve, so be careful with that. So from here, you can grab hold of the stick and pull up and pin that spot. Once I've got that spot pinned, I'm going to straighten out my leg. Now, the hamstrings, what they do in action is that they flex the knee and they also extend the hip. So by sitting, I'm already flexing the hip, which is already starting to put a little bit of stretch on this side. So we pin down that spot that's tender, and we straighten out our knee. Pin it down, straighten. We've got a good spot, we can work through there. Now as we come to the outside of the knee, we're on the fleshy part of that, the sciatic nerve actually splits into two nerves. One's called the common peroneal, the other one's called the tibial nerve. And when we get over to this tendon-like structure, and some of the muscle part, that's where the common peroneal nerve also sits. So just like if you've got that burning pain, you're going to feel a pain down into this part of the leg, realize you might be on it, and you just might have to shift over a bit. Pin it down, straighten it out. We can go to the other side, same thing, pin it down, straighten out. If you're not quite getting it with this, you might actually be onto the groin muscles, the adductor muscles, and I've got a video on that that can explain what you can do to self-myofascial release those. Lastly, we want to get right up near the top of the hamstring, which what I could do is I could sit on this and straighten, but if I don't have one of these, I can use a ball. A cross ball might work nicely. I can also use the stick all the way up there, and in this case, I'm going to stand and I'm going to show you. So I'm pinning right near the bony part. Just above the stick is that bony part. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to pin it down, and I'm going to bend forward. And again, that's another way I can stretch out that area. Now, for some people, the problem up in that area might actually be a hamstring tendonitis. And when we bend over, that tendon wraps around the bony part of the butt, and that can actually be aggravating. So that may not necessarily be the best thing to do, especially early on when that area is aggravated. So there's a bunch of ways that you can attempt to self-myofascial release your hamstring muscles.